So I welcome you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Welcome to morning prayer, a special welcome to you if you're joining us for the first time this morning. We're aiming to set aside half an hour or so, it's often a little longer, just to sit with the liturgy of morning prayer from the Church of England. So let's begin. Please do add a comment, give us a like or a heart, just let me know that you're there, if you're happy to do that. And you can add topics for prayer too. So let's begin. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Hear our voice, O Lord, according to your faithful love. According to your judgment, give us life. Blessed are you, God of compassion and mercy. To you be praise and glory forever. In the darkness of our sin, your light breaks forth like the dawn, and your healing springs up for deliverance. As we rejoice in the gift of your saving help, sustain us with your bountiful spirit, and open our lips to sing your praise. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. And a song of penitence, words from Psalm 51. Have mercy on me, O God, in your great goodness. According to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my offences. Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my faults, and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence and righteous in your judgment. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Give me again the joy of your salvation, and sustain me with your gracious Spirit. Then shall I teach your ways to the wicked, and sinners shall return to you. Deliver me from my guilt, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. Our psalm this morning is Psalm 22, and there is a refrain, and the refrain is, be not far from me, O Lord. Be not far from me, O Lord. My God, why have you forsaken me? And are so far from my salvation, from the words of my distress. O my God, I cry in the daytime, but you do not answer. And by night also, but I find no rest. Yet you are the Holy One, enthroned upon the praises of Israel. Our forebears trusted in you. They trusted and you delivered them. They cried out to you and were delivered. They put their trust in you and were not confounded. Be not far from me, O Lord. But as for me, I am a worm and no man, scorned by all and despised by the people. All who see me laugh me to scorn. They curl their lips and wag their heads, saying, He trusted in the Lord, let him deliver him. Let him deliver him if he delights in him. But it is you that took me out of the womb and laid me safe upon my mother's breast. On you was I cast ever since I was born. You are my God, even from my mother's womb. Be not far from me, for trouble is near at hand, and there is none to help. Be not far from me, O Lord. Mighty oxen came around me, fat bulls of Bashan closed me in on every side. They gaze upon me with their mouths, as if were a ramping and a roaring lion. I am poured out like water, all my bones are out of joint. My heart has become like wax, melting in the depths of my body. My mouth is dried up like a potsherd. My tongue cleaves to my gums. You have laid me in the dust of death. Be not far from me, O Lord. For the hounds are all about me, the pack of evildoers close in on me. They pierce my hands and my feet. I can count all my bones. They stand staring and looking upon me. They divide my garments among them. They cast lots for my clothing. Be not far from me, O Lord. You are my strength. Hasten to help me. Deliver my soul from the sword, my poor life from the power of the dog. Save me from the lion's mouth, from the horns of wild oxen. You have answered me. Be not far from me, O Lord. I will tell of your name to my people. In the midst of the congregation will I praise you. Praise the Lord, you that fear him. O seed of Jacob, glorify him. Stand in awe of him, O seed of Israel. For he has not despised nor abhorred the suffering of the poor, neither has he hidden his face from them. But when they cried to him, he heard them. From you comes my praise in the great congregation. I will perform my vows in the presence of those that fear you. The poor shall eat and be satisfied. Those who seek the Lord shall praise him. Their hearts shall live forever. Be not far from me, O Lord. All the ends of the earth shall remember and turn to the Lord, and all the families of the nation shall bow before him. For the kingdom is the Lord's, and he rules over the nations. How can those who sleep in the earth bow down and worship, or those who go down to the dust kneel before him? He has saved my life for himself. My descendants shall serve him. They shall be told of the Lord for generations to come. They shall come and make known his salvation to a people yet unborn, declaring that he, the Lord, has done it. Be not far from me, O Lord. Glory to the Father and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Our Old Testament this morning, we continue with the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Today, chapter 6, beginning at verse 22 through to the end. So if you're joining us for the first time, Israel is about to go into exile, and Jeremiah has a very difficult message to give to the people of Judah and Israel because they have strayed far from the Lord. Thus says the Lord, see, a people is coming from the land of the north. A great nation is stirring from the farthest parts of the earth. They grasp the bow and javelin. They are cruel and have no mercy. Their sound is like the roaring sea. They ride on horses, equipped like a warrior for battle against you, O daughter Zion. We have heard news of them. Our hands fall helpless. Anguish has taken hold of us. Pain as of a woman in labour. Do not go out into the field or walk on the road, for the enemy has a sword. Terror is on every side. O my poor people, put on sackcloth and roll in ashes. Make mourning as for an only child. Most bitter lamentation, for suddenly the destroyer will come upon us. I have made you a tester and a refiner among my people, so that you may know and test their ways. They are stubbornly rebellious, going about with slanders. They are bronze and iron. All of them act corruptly. The bellows blow fiercely. The lead is consumed by the fire. In vain the refining goes on, for the wicked are not removed. They are called rejected silver, for the Lord has rejected them. Here ends our first lesson. And our canticle this morning, the Song of Manasseh. There's a refrain at the very beginning and the end, which you may like to join in. This is the refrain. Full of compassion and mercy and love is God the Most High, the Almighty. Full of compassion and mercy and love is God the Most High, the Almighty. Lord Almighty and God of our ancestors, you who made heaven and earth in all their glory, all things tremble with awe at your presence, before your great and mighty power. Immeasurable and unsearchable is your promised mercy, for you are God Most High. You are full of compassion, long-suffering, and very merciful, and you relent at human suffering. O God, according to your great goodness, you have promised forgiveness for repentance to those who have sinned against you. The sins I have committed against you are more in number than the sands of the sea. I am not worthy to look up to the height of heavens because of the multitude of my iniquities. And now I bend the knee of my heart before you, imploring your kindness upon me. I have sinned, O God, I have sinned, and I acknowledge my transgressions. Unworthy as I am, you will save me, according to your great mercy. For all the host of heaven sings your praise, and your glory is for ever and ever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Full of compassion and mercy and love is God the Most High, the Almighty. And our Gospel reading this morning is from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6, verses 16 to 27. So yesterday we had the feeding of the 5,000. This is what happened next. When evening came, his disciples went down to the lake, got into a boat and started across the lake to Capernaum. It was now dark and Jesus had not yet come to them. The lake became rough because a strong wind was blowing. When they had rowed about 3 or 4 miles, they saw Jesus walking on the lake and coming near the boat. And they were terrified. But he said to them, "It is I. Do not be afraid." Then they wanted to take him into the boat. And immediately the boat reached the land towards which they were going. The next day the crowd that had stayed on the other side of the lake saw that there had been only one boat there. They also saw that Jesus had not got into the boat with his disciples, but that his disciples had gone away alone. Then some boats from Tiberias came near the place where they had eaten the bread after the Lord had given thanks. So when the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into the boats and went to Capernaum looking for Jesus. When they found him on the other side of the lake, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you come here?" Jesus answered them, "Very truly I tell you, you are looking for me, not because you saw signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. Do not work for the food that perishes, but the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For it is on him that God the Father has set his seal." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We usually have a little pause. I'll just check back on the comments. I'm not sure if anything may have resonated for you from our readings. And our response to Scripture. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. O my God, in you I trust. You are the God of my salvation. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. In you I hope all the day long. O my God, in you I trust. Remember, Lord, your compassion and love, for they are from everlasting. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. O my God, in you I trust. And words from the Benedictus, the Song of Zechariah. There is a refrain at the very beginning and the end. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, God promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our ancestors, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies. Free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. So I'm just checking for your any prayer requests that might be here. We'll pray for Carol and her mum's anniversary today, 30 years. And we've got a note from Judith about our scripture reading, the thing that struck her this morning. Do not work for the food that perishes, but for eternal life, which the Son of Man gives you. Conscious of Kath's dad, nearing the end of his earthly life. We pray for all who are in between the two worlds, so to speak. And I think it's important that we do that because there's still so many deaths at the moment, at this point in the pandemic, in the UK and around the world. God's holding them and you, Judith, and we hold each other. That's from Tracy. Thank you for praying and caring for one another. So let us pray now. Just thinking about what Jesus said about not setting on our hearts on the food that will perish, but that eternal food, that eternal life. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Heavenly Father, in this time of Lent, we often reflect on your Son, Jesus, in the desert, in the wilderness, without food, often without water. Tempted as he was to turn a stone into bread. Help us to see the true living water, that Jesus is bread of life. And not to be too focused on our next meal, in a world where so many go hungry, in a world where so many children are malnourished, and in the UK, where food poverty is on the rise. We thank you for all those who will gift food this weekend for local food banks from wherever we are gathered. Help us to keep our eyes fixed on you. Your love for everyone. The dignity of every human life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As our breakfast clubs get ready to reopen and after school activities, when schools return next month, we pray for our head teachers, support staff, through all the tiers of education. We think of our leaders and support teams in universities too. for pupils and students in all places. Let us not be focused on the catching up and the element that children and young people have not been able to do. Let us celebrate the fact that they have managed to do what they have done. Let us celebrate the fact that parents have managed to juggle so many things, including heavier support for education. May our children and young people who have persevered through this last year have developed resilience, flexibility, determination to study, truly value the education system and go on to great things. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for all who are struggling with the pandemic at this time, directly or indirectly, especially where it's affecting people's mental health. We pray for anyone waking up in residential care this morning. We pray for people waiting for a diagnosis. We pray for people and their families who have concerns that they will seek help today. And that compassionate help will be found and the support that they need. We also pray for all who are battling eating disorders at this time. We pray for healing for them and their families. And we pray for all who are caring for a loved one at this time. Pray for energy, patience, calmness, wisdom, and love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for all who are struggling in mind, body, or spirit this morning. We pray for our communities from where we are gathered. And in our parish here, we lift before you today, Lord, John Ellison, Jessica McCaskill, Carrie Waggett, Betty Connor, Doreen Moig, Andrew Garvick, Mrs. Hewitt, Sid Harrison, Pat Middleton, Dorothy Macbeth, Stella Matthews, Michael Hughes, Chris Haynes, Tom McKenzie, Julie, Josh, Pat Henshaw, John Pike, Anne Taylor, Rod Taylor, Carol Woodfield, Christine, Beatrice Yorston, Wyn Aldersleard. Marion, Judith and Jen, Grant and Sheena, Gillian, Karen Hill, Reverend Stuart Hill, John Young, Minnie Johannesson, Mavis, Harriet Fraser, Grant Macbeth, Susan Fisher, Ruth Banks, James Shepherd, Marjorie Carruthers, Brian Henderson, Anne Henderson, Brenda Prophet, Marilyn Merrin. And in a time of silence, Lord, we lift to you those people on our hearts this morning. May they know your healing presence, your comfort and your peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, we pray for those people who are more seriously ill today. Anyone for whom today may be their last day in this place, praying for all who care for them, all who may be deeply distressed at this time. We pray for the souls of those who sit between earth and heaven. And ask you to welcome them home to your open arms. We pray for all who are grieving at this time, planning or attending funerals, praying for the family of Margaret Errington and the family and friends of Dr. Bex Lewis. And we lift to you also anyone whose memorial falls at this time. We pray for their families, lifting to you this morning, Carol and her family. We commend all those we love but no longer see into your eternal care, Lord. Let light perpetual shine upon them. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. And our collect for today, Almighty God, whose Son Jesus Christ fasted 40 days in the wilderness and was tempted as we are, yet without sin, give us grace to discipline ourselves in obedience to your Spirit. And as you know our weakness, so may we know your power to save. through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And trusting in the compassion of God, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. May God, our Redeemer, show us compassion and love. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. And thank you for joining us today.